I said in an earlier video that I would start getting into assembly probably on video number three, but on this one I'll still be introducing some of the tools we'll be using, so you might want to skip ahead one more if you want to jump straight into assembly. On my last video on basic, I was just wrapping up the video when there was somebody at the door. And I still wanted to cover one more thing. So, a nice feature about using Vice, as I showed you earlier, the editing on the Commodore 64 is rather clunky by today's standards. So you can use any text editor to do your coding, and then bring it over if you like. And what's nice about that here, I can just, like, you find some code on the internet or something, you can just copy it off the internet and then, paste it in there. Or here, Alt Insert, So I'm going to just hit Alt Insert. Okay. Now, observe that there's a bunch of kind of funky looking characters. That's not what we pasted. So if this happens to you, this is because someone has written the code in all capital letters. As you may have noticed, like whatever you type, although I'm typing regular text, you only see the capital letters on the screen. So what people do to make it look more like the code that you're seeing on your Commodore is to put the code samples in all capital letters, and this is what you get. So like if I were to hold a shift key and hit the same keys, see, you get all these symbols. That's the next set of characters or whatever in the computer. So that's why you're getting all this weirdness. The way to fix that, if you have an advanced text editor such as Notepad plus, most of them will have convert case. Okay, and I am just gonna convert that to lowercase. And now, if I copy that, and I'm going to go over here and go New and Alt Insert. There. See, now the code looks fine. So that fixes that. So now I can run that program. Oops, I forgot the print command. Okay, so this would be list da, 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 40. Print C. Enter. Now that bit of code should be added. There it is. I can now run this program and it prints out. There. So that is running. Okay. So if you want to publish in assembly for the Commodore 64 and you're using Visual Studio, there is a plugin or whatever you call it for Visual Studio called the Kick Assembler, if that's what you're familiar with. But the code with Microsoft, they always have to Microsoftify everything. So code examples that you find are not going to be compatible with, 95% of the other assemblers in the world, So what I will be using is called CBM PRG, available at this address. And you can go there to the download, and grab. They only have this version. Now, the thing is, you may find a bunch of slightly older tutorials on YouTube or whatever, and the newer version does not work quite the same as the version that you're seeing in all the videos. Now, if I go over here to YouTube, a cat named The Stuff Made has a few really nice tutorial videos getting started with sprites and such, and on it's called Retro Programming on the Commodore 64. And if you go to episode 2, he has been kind enough, if you click click on Show More to include a link here for the older version, 3.13. I could post my own download spot, but I had Dropbox once before and I posted some things for download, and then a few months later they emailed me that they're canceling my account due to inactivity, you know, and I'm not messing with that, you know. I've put stuff on YouTube 20 years ago that's still up there, you know. But so as long as this link is going to last, you know, you can find an older version, version 3.13, which is what I'm using and everybody else seems to be using for their tutorials. Because so let's go to CBM Studio. It looks like that, and it's a integrated environment that will go directly to Vice. You know, you can publish some code here, and then in 3.13, if I just click the publish button like this, da-da, and it's all in capitals, so it should automatically launch Vice and run the program. Oh, look at that. Even though it's capitals here, it ran it. So Vice. A CBM PRG Studio automatically converted my capital letters on the fly. Nice, nice. Okay, this allows you to create programs in both BASIC and or assembly. Yeah. So anyways, in version 3.13, all you have to do is click this and it will launch the program for you. But if you download the newer version, you probably have to hit build, that's this one here, and then go and save the project there, and then you can launch the program and it should work. But that's just too many steps, you know, for development. Okay. So let me just talk about the book that I'm going to be using here. If you go to, here it is, commodore.bombjack.org/commodore/books.htm, there is a wealth of 30-plus-year-old books, you know, for those of you that just love throwing money at something every time you want to go learn something and then never look at the books anyways. You don't need to, because, you know, the Commodore is 40 years old and all the books were written decades ago. You know, and so this is a great resource. It's got all the old books. Many of them come with the software that came with the book, you know. So let's see the book that I am going to be using. See if I can find it on the list here. Probably down here under assembly. Yada yada. Machine language and assembly programming. So here's the book I'm going to be using, Commodore 64 Assembly Language Programming. And when I looked at this previously at this other book, Dr. Watson Computer Learning Series, I was trying to start here, and then I happened to look at this book, and it's identical at the beginning. So this book is the newer version of this book, so I'm just going to be using that. So most of the code samples use the assembler that came with the book, which uses a slightly different language than the assembler that I'm using, CBM PRG. So it took a little messing around to translate between all the code samples in this book, so to make it compatible with CBM. But I've done that, and so I'm going to be drawing quite a bit from this book if you wanted to download that and follow along. you can, and you can also mess around with the, this comes with an assembler that also disassembles. So it takes all of the assembled code and turns it back into assembly language. So that's a nice little feature. There are other disassemblers around that you can get that are you can use with the modern code examples as well. Okay, so this will be where my lessons will be drawn from primarily in the beginning stages. So there you go. You can grab that and if you like. And as I said, lots of books on the Commodore. Ones that don't say what language it is, it means just generally basic. Yeah. And then other ones are written for machine language and assembly language, you know, which is the bulk of these tutorials.